Carnage is barely trailing behind.
Yeah. Now, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., I have very mixed
opinions. Oh
man,
you have been talking a long time about how you wanted to go on a long rant about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
I have very mixed feelings about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Oh my god, they're digging up the road outside my house. I can hear it. So, first series is great. It's just Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. It's exactly what you expect from the title of the show. It goes through, it's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. It reaches a point where it matches up to Winter Soldier. They have to deal with Hydra infiltrating the whole thing. S.H.I.E.L.D. all crumbles towards the end of the series. And then by the end, Nick Fury's like, "Right, I'm leaving S.H.I.E.L.D. behind. You're now director. Rebuild it." And the first series is great. The second series then deals with, like, it's a bit of a mix of dealing with, yeah. The second series, like, so how is Coulson even alive? The second series deals with that. And that's also really good. And then towards the end of the second series is where it gets, like, what? So they find, like, it's kind of cool concept. There's like alien civilization kind of stuff, and they've built like the Kree have built like temples underground in some places, and there's this like thing they call the obelisk, and some people can touch it and they're fine touching it, whereas if other people touch it they turn into stone and die. And the way it determines if you can touch it and you can't is if you have an inhuman gene which was genetically engineered into humans by the Kree. And on its own, that is a really cool idea. It's clearly there just because they didn't have the rights to the mutants. But it's still a pretty cool idea. So they go through that, they get to the alien city, and then one of the main characters' agents turns out to have that gene, and they get powers, and they can like basically, they can control the vibrations of atoms, and it's all really cool. Then the problem arises. This is like middle of series 2, I think. Yeah. The problem starts to arise when they find an entire like civilization of these people who have gained powers from it. And they have like crystals that you can, if you break open, it releases a mist, which either kills people or turns the inhuman gene into like have powers. And there's like a fight on this ship. Oh yeah, there's also a subplot where there's like a second branch of S.H.I.E.L.D. that rebuilt it by themselves that don't believe that Nick Fury gave Coulson the director thing. That's also a weird side plot. So they fight, there's like a S.H.I.E.L.D. fight, S.H.I.E.L.D. v. S.H.I.E.L.D. fight kind of on that ship. And then at the same time, the Inhumans show up and they try and kill all of S.H.I.E.L.D. because S.H.I.E.L.D. wants to kill them. And then in the during the entire thing, the crystals end up falling into the water and they dissolve, which gets rid of the part that kills people, but keeps the part that makes the powers. And then it disperses across the entire planet, which means there's now, like, so many, probably millions of people all around the world that have this gene. That if they come into any contact with, like, fish products, they just get powers. And this is where it, like...
You eat a lobster at some sort of fancy restaurant.
Yeah, and you just... But the way you get powers is you literally turn into stone for a bit. And then you break out of that cocoon with powers. But sometimes it'll be physical changes, or sometimes it'll literally just be powers.
Oh, alright.
But it's at that point where it's like... So everything before that point is like, yeah, I can see this being in the MCU. It's made a real effort to link itself to the MCU. Phil Coulson even, like, they reference all the MCU events. They help out in... They indirectly help in Age of Ultron by supplying the helicarrier and everything. And then it just gets to that point where they just cover the entire planet in superpowered people just in time for the Sokovia Accords to happen. And you're like,
What?
This doesn't make any sense. So they still reference the Sokovia Accords.
So, like, you would say that it's that the first 2.5 seasons are all right.
The first season is in the MCU and it's good. The first half of the second season would definitely be in the MCU and it's good. Everything after that point is it goes off its own, it's still a good show, but it just goes off on its complete own tangent and just gets crazier and crazier and crazier until it's just like, this isn't even a Marvel show anymore. This is just a random sci-fi show with Marvel in the title.
So where would you put it?
I'm going to say highest C. The highest on the C tier.
Better than Spider-Man 3.
Probably. Really like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Actually, maybe not better than Spider-Man 3. Actually, more now I think about it. I'll put it here instead.
Oh my god, poor Doctor Strange. This is the most scuffed tier list ever. If anyone sees this, you're gonna get fucking cancelled. Or something.
So, Luke Cage, I haven't actually finished it yet. I haven't actually finished it properly yet. I'm moving on.
Again, why doesn't he have a superpower name?
His name isn't actually Luke Cage. That's his. He uses a different name because he went to prison or something. But his power is literally, his skin is indestructible and he has super strength.
I heard he's like a hero for hire or something.
I don't know, we might get to that later on in the show. I just haven't finished watching the show yet.
Alright, so but where would you put it?
Right now, and if it carries on going as it is, I would probably put it somewhere in D tier.
Yikes.
I might actually just chuck it on the end of D tier.
Yeah, just to be safe.
It's okay. I'm basically just watching it as background noise at this point. It's not too enjoyable.
Future Will here, I was way too harsh on this. This is nowhere near as bad as Black Widow. but yeah, we'll be making we'll probably rectify a lot of decisions once the TLS is finished, in quotes. anyway, back to where you were.
Agent Carter. I'm just going to go ahead and put that right there.
Don't want to talk about it.
It's just kind of like you expect it to be something, and then it's just like you expect it to be somewhat cool, and then for some reason it's a sci-fi show instead of just a 1950s spy show.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
So about these five over here, you haven't watched.
I feel like I might have watched Runaways. I'll have to see what Runaways is.
Let's just not rank them, just in case.
Yeah. I mean, if we were going off what other people, like everyone else's opinions, right? We would have probably like these here.
Yeah, but the internet.
But the internet disagrees with a lot of my opinions.
The internet is very, very. The problem with the internet, it's very, very polar. If you know what I mean, it's very like it would argue, it would probably say that Ant-Man is an S tier MCU film.
Yeah.
And would say that everything in B is an S tier film, everything in A is an S tier.
Yeah.
It would say everything in C is a C tier film, and then everything D and below is shit and awful, and that's the problem with it. It's very polar and it's very extreme.
Yeah.
It's either the best thing ever, mediocre as shit, or fucking awful.
Yeah.
When you were talking about Inhumans and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., I got an idea. Do you want to talk about the X-Men films briefly, maybe?
We could. The X-Men films definitely are not going to be part of the MCU. We should tell them the truth. I feel like they want to do that their own way.
Then forget about it.
I feel so, like, yeah, this... we might want to include Deadpool 1 and Deadpool 2, though, because knowing Deadpool, he will reference them when he gets his MCU film.
He gets an MCU film?
Yeah, they've confirmed they're going to be making a R-rated Deadpool MCU film with Ryan Reynolds still. So it's just the same it's going to be Deadpool 3, but it's in the MCU.
So if you want to put them in, you can, and you have full control.
I'll just leave it as it is, because it would be too difficult to... Because it's such a different type of film, it's too difficult to compare it.
This looks like a pretty good lineup. I think that this is pretty consistent and makes sense. I personally would make a few changes to it.
Yeah, I feel like we might make a few changes, because I feel like there might be some changes to make.
But, like, yeah. No Way Home, fucking great, not a competition.
Yeah.
Well, it kind of is. Infinity War is an incredible film, and so is Endgame, but why?
No Home's just amazing.
The worst film in the series, Thor Dark World, is mediocre, which should tell you that the MCU is pretty good.
Yeah.
And the only two properties that are less than that is a...
They weren't even made by Marvel Studios. They were made by Marvel TV.
Yeah, so... just like... you could, if you guys want to like screenshot this and tell us how shit our opinions are, go rage in the comments for the five of you that actually care. this is the ultimate tier list. If you disagree with us, you're wrong.
Yes.
I am always right. Look at my cool PFP that Will made for me. Look at it, it's beautiful. I am right, you are wrong. I am always right, so shut up. Okay,
So that's the tier list.
We've been doing this for about 2 hours now.
Yeah, this definitely... Over. This might be like a four-part video.
Definitely. How will it end up, we'll say.
Yeah.
I have a feeling that you'll like split it up into like 15-minute parts or whatever.
Probably.
Or you'll probably split it up into like years.
Yeah, that could work.
Like from 2002 to like, maybe you'll have like a video on like 2002 to like 2009 or till Avengers or whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm coming.
This was a lot of fun. Let's hope, fingers crossed, that OBS didn't fuck up.
Yes. Let me just save this.
Too lost.
I'll save it to MCM. No, I'll just save it here. I'll just save it as MCU.
Why do you have a picture of a glass in your folder?
Oh, because it's for the emojis for Discord.
Oh, alright, okay.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Thanks everyone for if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. And like and comment.